Hello everyone, in this video we will teach you how to save different things like integer, a string, float in Unity. Let's save with us, let's go.
To start, create a new script named as save or whatever you want. Then create a game object, now drag the script towards it and open the script. Remove useless parts. Let's get to what this video made for. One way of saving information in Unity is PlayerPrefs. With PlayerPrefs, you can save float, integer, and a string in Unity. To save information, use these lines of code. Let's get to how save integer. Here write a name that you want integer saves with that name, like coin. And beside that, write its number like 100. With this, you save 100 named as coin in PlayerPrefs. Actually, this is simplest way to save integer. To save a string, do this too. Just put set a string instead of setInt. And in double quotation, write a string owner and what name or anything else that belongs to a string owner. Here, as you see, I saved Daniel as username in PlayerPrefs. To save float, do exactly what you did before, only use float stuff. Now you can save integer, a string, and float in PlayerPrefs. If this is not understandable for you, it's completely natural. We show you some examples ahead to understand it full. Let's see how load informations with PlayerPrefs works. It's easier actually. Get integer or get a string or get float. In get at parentheses, only write the owner title. In this way, you can load whatever you saved before. Generally, we can save with set and load saved stuff with get. Now let's see an interesting example to complete understanding. We want with any click on this button, coin's number increases by 200 and this number saved. And whenever I quit the game and re-enter the game, this number will be loaded and displayed. Because you have a lot of works with UI, use UnityEngine.UI. Then define an integer named as coin to manage coin's number, and to display number of coins, define a text like coin text. To increase coin's number by clicking on this button, you need a new void. So create a new void and name it raise or whatever you want. If you don't know how to work with UI buttons, don't miss above video. In the raise void, increase coin's number, and for display, use this line of code. Now for saving coins number, use setInt and name the coins title as you want, like my coins. And number of coins is the coin integer that got defined before. Now what happens, coins number saves as my coins title in the PlayerPrefs. Drag the text of coins number towards the script. Then give the main object to the button and choose the raise void from functions. Now after play, you will see by clicking on this button, coins number increases by 200. But on a stop and replay, coins number will be 0 again, cause no save or load code is written. To fix this, open save script and at a start void, do this. You will ask why a start, cause when user plays the game, first void executes is a start. So loading codes must be written in start void. Of course, a wake void runs sooner than a start, but we don't use and don't need it for now. Now for loading coins number, you need to equal coin integer to get int of saved integer's title. To displaying coins number, use this line of code as you used before. Now after play, you will see coins are loaded and displayed very nicely. And if you click on this button, coins number increases and saves. And on a stop or re-enter, it loads without problem. Sometimes you need to remove all of your saved data. For this, use PlayerPrefs.Delete All. Now if you play, you will see your coins number equal to 0, cause it has been resetted. Sometimes you want, instead of deleting all saves, delete a special saved stuff. For this, use delete key and in parentheses, write that title which saved thing belongs to it. I hope this tutorial was useful for you. In general, saving is one of the most important and yet simple things in Unity.
Next tutorial is about creating shop in Unity. Don't forget to like and subscribe us. Thank you.